Without further ado, I'll welcome our guest, Joe Santos. Welcome to the show.
Hello, JD. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks for coming on, man. Being willing to share your bold inventor experience and talk about what you've invented here.
Well, I invented a new technology to extract energy from flowing water. And I didn't mean to try to do something really different, but in doing so and going through the exercises, I've learned that it's quite unique. It's capable of doing some really remarkable things. And I'm now getting ready to try to share it with people so that they can use it.
Cool. So tell us about what this is. How does it generate, you said, store energy?
No, it harnesses energy from flowing water. Right now, from what I've learned, all the current technologies require a significant velocity to extract energy. And my technique is to use marine grade parachutes, which extract the energy by volume rather than velocity. So it allows us to extract energy from very, very low speed water flows that are globally available and right now virtually untapped by existing technologies.
Got it. So this word extracting energy. Okay. Tell me what that means.
Well, unlike existing technologies that extract kinetic energy, this device builds potential energy for conversion to kinetic energy. And that potential energy offers different benefits. For example, the ability to, say, pump water or pump oxygen without electricity. You know, it's just mechanical work. And as these canopies, these marine grade parachutes pull from the flow, you can imagine it creates quite enormous line tension or pull force. And this pull force can be used to lift a weight, create hydraulic pressure, turn a generator, things like that. So multiple uses. It's just something really new. And as a matter of fact, just yesterday, I met a gentleman that came up with a new use for it, and he would like to partner and look into a new industry. And yeah, it's really, really exciting. It's just new physics. You know, it's very simple. So far, the professors, the researchers that have looked at it said, man, how's it? Nobody's thought of it. It's kind of obvious. So yeah, I'm really excited to share it because it's easy to pick up on.
Awesome. And that's one of the areas that I know some of our inventors have taken before. Tell me about how that began, you know, working with universities and professors, and how has that gone, in your opinion?
Well, it's going well. It's still going pretty well. I think for me, it may not be like it may not be applicable to all inventions, but for this, because I think there's such an interest in renewable energy and energy generation, because it's doing something so novel, that once like mechanical engineering professors and things like that started hearing about it, they were really interested and wanted to teach their students about it, things like that. I actually got into a couple of UCs and things like that through these accelerator programs, Blue Tech Valley for one. I hate to mention names, but you know, just the accelerators that are interested in renewable energy, yeah. They want to spread the word. So
let's talk about your overall approach to commercialization, right? So patent law, as you probably know, is about getting rights to exclude anyone else from doing this. Although this seems a little bit counter to that, where you're doing research and developing. How have you, you know, planned your business and making money part of this?
I didn't really start this project as a money-making idea. I just kind of wanted to see if it could be done, knowing that it would be valuable to people. And I think my interests are more for the social and economic environmental benefits. So my idea was to patent it and hopefully sell it. And because it has the potential for other companies to make money, energy producers or people that want to save the planet, you know, I would love to enable and empower them or enable them to make money or to start systems and encourage widespread adoption to help fight climate change. You know, I think my technology is simple enough that it can empower really simple and remote communities, things like that, and start something really new.
Sounds great. I want to share your website. Maybe you could have us kind of talk through as I scroll through some of these pictures.
This video is of a novel renewable energy resource.
Hi, my name is.
You know, nobody can. So far, no other technologies can extract energy from these types of water resources. And so, to tell people that this can be done is really difficult. You know, they don't believe it. It's been studied for over 100 years. You know, turbine technologies, they've been chasing these resources forever. But my technology is non-turbine, and where other technologies require 15 meters of tidal range or 6 foot per second velocities to extract energy, my technology is able to work in 3 foot tidal ranges, and our sweet spot is going to be 2 to 3 foot per second velocities, which are common within the San Francisco Bay just during a tidal ebb and flow. You know, a small 5 to 6 foot tidal change in the San Francisco Bay creates ebb and flow throughout the entire San Francisco Bay of, you know.
If you could kind of walk us through what we're looking at in terms of this parachute and how the, you know, the potential energy is stored, where would I see that? Is there some sort of battery? Walk me through what we're looking at.
This system here creates very little potential energy. This is just an overhead shot for me to observe the motion of the canopy, but this canopy would actually be housed inside of a cylinder. And the cylinder would have a pen area that would allow the water to enter the pen area, go through the cylinder, as you can see there, and then hit and then impact the canopy. When the canopy is expanded, it creates a steady state and head within the pen area. And just a small amount of head, say just 1 to 2 inches of head, actually creates pressure or potential energy. So this is some new physics that we are now come to find out, that this amount of potential energy that we can build by sacrificing half of that to create kinetic energy, we can extract more kinetic energy than any other technology, and more than they say is theoretically available without the pen area. Water flow through a cylinder in these dimensions, currently they say can only extract so much energy, but they didn't think about the, you know, the head, the inside the pen area and things like that, the potential energy versus the kinetic energy.
Yeah, it's wonderful having you on. I just want to thank you so much. I'm sorry the connection wasn't perfect, but I really appreciate you coming out and making time for us and sharing what you've done with Hydrochute. So we'll have you backstage hanging out as we go to the next stage. See you, Joe.